Hey everybody, and welcome to the video. This week I've got something a little bit different for you. I'm going to be pulling a clip from my most recent Patreon stream about dieting and calories in versus calories out and which foods are best for weight loss. So if you want to hear that, stay tuned. And if you do want to see more streams like this, be sure to sign up for my Patreon page at patreon.com/joshfenn. I do live streams every Thursday for people that want to support the channel. Thanks so much. Enjoy the video. I'll talk to you next week. I've been helping out a new Patreon supporter. Been helping them out with getting set up and started with their weight loss. They've been having a very difficult time believing me that calories in versus calories out is the main thing that matters for weight loss. They keep coming back to me saying, you know, I haven't been eating any bad carbs for a week now, and like talking about it like it's a good thing. You know, there are no bad or good carbs. There are no bad or good calories. You can lose 200 pounds eating Big Macs. You can gain 200 pounds by eating salad. The types of foods don't matter strictly for your weight loss. You know, there are some asterisks to that. You know, it's important to have healthy food for your overall health, and eating healthier and lower calorie foods can help get a lot more food volume. But at the end of the day, it really is just about the amount of calories. It took me a lot of years and a lot of failure and a lot of practice and a lot of experience to get to that point, to realize it's as simple as you dread it to be. But yeah, calories are all that matters. And that's why I'm such a big advocate for tracking calories. I've been even moving away more so from tracking, you know, macronutrients like protein and fat and carbs. There's definitely benefit for that, but at the end of the day, the calories is what matters most strictly for weight loss. And someone had put in a comment on one of my videos. They summed it up really well for the calorie input versus the macronutrients. You know, your calorie goal is what's going to determine your weight, and your macronutrients are what determine your body composition. So think of that as more of an advanced move if you're someone trying to lose weight. You know, focus on the calories to start, and once you are comfortable and have a good grasp on that, then you can start worrying about things like macronutrients, because that does come into play and it is important. The amount of fat that you're getting is really important for hormones. You know, the amount of protein you eat is really important to maintain muscle mass. The amount of carbs you have is really important for energy at the gym or just general day to day. You know, all of the macronutrients matter for different reasons, but not necessarily for your weight. That number of pounds on the scale is unaffected by the macros. It's all about the calories. And I do think with you know, eating healthier foods versus unhealthier foods, over time, you'll kind of self-correct into things that are going to fit better into your day. So technically, yeah, you could eat 3 Snickers bars every day on your diet and you could still successfully lose weight. But most likely, if you're spending, you know, I think Snickers bars are probably like 250 to 300 calories. So say you're spending 750 to 900 calories of your day on Snickers bars, over time, you're going to realize I'm still hungry. And so you'll figure out, well, instead of the Snickers bar, maybe I'll eat a bowl of oatmeal, which you get, you know, 3 or 4 times more food volume and ends up being a lot more filling just with oats. Things like that will kind of self-correct over time with practice and experience, because it's impossible to try and start with that list of foods that are going to work, because you don't know, and you can go off of what someone else is saying, but there's no cookie cutter example of a proper diet that fits into everyone's schedules and lives and their taste. You know, it's all different. You can get ideas and examples from other people, but you really need to take the time to learn that for yourself. That's the only way you're going to figure out what works best, is if you try and fail and experiment, and then you figure out what's best for you and what's going to keep you on track. So just make sure that if you are trying to lose weight, track your calories. That really is all that matters. You know, you can run yourself blind in the gym and make mistakes that you didn't even realize you're making to cancel out all of that. You know, the Snickers bar, for instance, you'd have to run for an hour to balance out that Snickers bar. So a little bit of planning, a little bit of practice and experience, and logging what you're doing is going to avoid a lot of those stupid mistakes that are easy to make, because you think, you know, I'm eating healthy and I'm working out every day. Why aren't I losing weight? Well, the reality is, you know, you're eating healthy. Say you're eating, you know, 2,500 calories, but your maintenance is 2,500 calories. You're not going to lose any weight no matter how healthy you're eating. So that's basically it. Track your calories. Don't worry about anything else. Your body and your mind will self-correct along the way with practice and experience. So even outside of the self-correcting and realizing which foods work and don't work, super, super important to make sure and allow yourself to have the things that you want to have. If you're relying on willpower to stay on track, you will fail. I tried. I have more determination than most people I know when it comes to trying to reach goals. Even coming from me, I failed many, many times trying to do this. You will fail if you rely on your willpower. So don't think of foods as bad or good, or foods that you can't ever have or foods that you can have, because during your diet, you're going to need to take care of yourself if you want to stay on track. And then also, too, even beside the actual weight loss itself, once the weight is gone, what are you going to do about those foods? You know, are you really going to live the rest of your life never eating one of your favorite foods? I don't think so. You need to learn how to tame the beast, so to speak. You need to figure out how to handle those feelings and those cravings and what to do about it and how to overcome them and how to fit them in your day. It's all very, very important. Don't banish foods. Don't worry about good foods or bad foods. Don't even necessarily worry about your macronutrients in the beginning or in the middle. If you don't ever want to get into macronutrients, I can guarantee you, you will have successful weight loss and maintenance without ever having to do that if you don't want. If you're more concerned with your physique or something, down the road, once you feel comfortable, add that stuff in, start tracking a little more specifically, but just take baby steps.